Hello friends, in last video we completed our setup to run the integration tests, right? To write our integration tests. So we have completed the Espresso setup. Now we'll write our first integration test in this video. So we are using my expense manager app which I have created, right? So on this particular page I want to test if this particular text is presented or not. Also, we'll see if this button is present on the screen or not, right? So let's start with that. Let's go to Android Studio. In this main activity, I don't have any test right now, right? So if you see in Android test, I don't have any test at all, right? It's an application test which is system generated. So let's start with writing test, create test, and I will create main activity test. It prompts me with two options, one is test and one is Android test. So remember, in all instrumentation tests are Android test. Test is just for the simple JUnit test, not for the instrumentation test. So we will choose Android test and say OK. So it has created main activity test class for us, right? So also, so first thing that we need is from this test, it should launch our application and start our main activity, right? To do that, Espresso provides a rule called activity test rule, right? And we create an instance of this rule with the main activity, right? What else it needs is, it needs the initial touch mode. That would be true, yes, that application should be touchable, and launch activity. So if you set this option as true, whenever your test runs, it will launch your activity automatically. For now, we'll keep it as false and we'll launch the activity in our test itself, right? So let's create our first test. I will name it as should render view. Right, so this is our test. Now what I want is, I want to see if this particular text present on the view or not, and to do that, first I need to launch my activity, right? And I can just say new intent, right? So I'm not passing anything in the intent because I have already told this rule that my activity would be main activity, so it will by default launch main activity itself, right? So now there is a matcher called own view provided by Espresso. This is basically to select a particular view. So now I want to select this particular view in the matcher, right? So for that I'll use with text, and we'll do a static import, and our text is string dot, let's see in the new expense text view. Yeah, this is the text that we are interested in, right? So I'll use this, import the R class, right? Now this particular part is to select the view, right? I'm saying on the view there would be a text with this particular string, select that, and then I will start with performing assertion. I'll say check, and check takes a view assertion. There's a method which provides a view assertion which is called matches, so we'll import that, and then it will take a view matcher. View matcher would be is displayed or not, so which is displayed. So what I'm saying is, when I launch this particular activity, the main activity, it should contain a text, add new expense, right? And it should be displayed. Also make sure you annotate your class with run with Android JUnit 4, right? So that we can write test in JUnit manner and tell it should run it in JUnit fashion. JUnit 4 fashion, right? So let's start the test. So I'll close this activity or this application. Now when I run the test, it will launch the application and perform this particular assertion. So let's do that. Choose your emotion. Now you would see it launches the application and checks the assertion. There you go. Activity was launched and it performed the assertion. And the test passed because this particular text is present. Right? So let's say I want to make the test fail. I'll say okay. I want to make sure that hello is present on the screen. That's what it checks, right? So now if I run the test, this particular assertion will pass, but this will fail because there is no text called hello on the screen, right? So let's run the test again. Launches the activity and checks for the assertions. So now let's see what it says, right? So it says no view hierarchy found matching with text hello. So it knows there's no text hello on the screen and the test is failed, right? So the main thing to remember here is this part is to select your view, any kind of view, and this part is to assert, right? Now let's say you can also argue like add new expense can be present anywhere, right? What if I have two add new expenses on the screen? What should I do? It will match two, right? There will be an ambiguous exception. So in that case, what you can do is we'll go to our new expense. You can give ID to this particular, let's say add new expense ID, right? Now ID would be unique, right? Now what you can say is own view with ID, and my ID is add new expense ID check matches with text, and text would be r dot string dot add new expense. Now we are making sure that this text is present on this ID, right? And now if I run the test, it will pass again because we have added ID in the view. So it's starting the test. It's compiling the files. Yeah, now it's running. And test passed, right? So it knows that this particular text is present on this particular ID. So guys, this is our first test where we are doing or asserting something on the view with the text. Similarly, you can check for the button as well. In the beginning, I told you that we'll be checking the button as well, button primary, right? And the ID is add expense. So you can say, okay, I want to make sure add expense is displayed, right? And your test is done. So this test will make sure two things: that add new expense is present on this particular text view, plus add expense button is displayed, right? So in our next video, we'll see more sophisticated tests and we'll see how to write them.